and welcome to this Unity tutorial on creating a progress shader or a fill shader or a shader that colors the object with two colors or any patterns if you would like to explore more. My starting point to work on this was it is potential to be a 3D progress bar in VR games or even in 3D games for an extra layer of dimension. You can find new ways to use it as well as start from that point. I have a written tutorial similar to this one in my blog, which will be linked in the description, as well as a very cool source from Coding Black that helped me understand the shaders and this kind of approach better. For this one, we will start by following the steps of creating a shader graph and applying it to a material. Then continue with the created shader graph, inspect its properties from the editor, then its design in shader graph editor, and lastly, there will be a coding demo to provide a direction on how you can use this shader with code. Let's start with the steps of creating the shader graph needed for this tutorial and setting it to a material. To create the shader graph, we start with right-click on Project window, Create, Shader, Universal Render Pipeline, Lead Shader Graph, and rename it, let's say Progress. Now we have a new shader. To use it, we need a new material. For creating the material, right-click on Project, Create, Material. Name it something like NewMat if you would like. Now we have two separate items that we need to combine. To do that, select the material, on Shader dropdown, select Shader Graphs and select the shader created earlier, or a target shader, which in this case is Progress Shader. The XYZ variations are for the namings for XYZ oriented falling behavior that I will touch when explaining the graph. When you want to implement and use this shader, you can follow the previous steps. I have already created the progress fill shader and will continue explaining from it. Before the walkthrough, let me introduce its properties from the editor. Now selecting an object with the shader, on its material we can inspect the values. This one has 4 expose property for us from the editor to edit. Fill rate is the position in target axis, which is x in the scene, that we aim to fill the object with fill color from negative position to positive position. Starting and end positions. Progress borders are either calculated within code or set on the editor. It is the half size of the mesh bounds the game object uses on the fill axis. Progress border is specific for the object. For example, it is 0.5 for this cube, sphere and capsule. It is the half size of the object mesh in its initial state, but it is different for hoop, 3D Mobius strip and plane, as their sizes differ too. When I set progress border to 0.5, we see clamps on fill behavior for the different objects. To fix it, you can try to set the value manually from the editor by giving a high value to fill rate and adjust progress border till you see no clamp in newly created materials. Or run the script and set the progress border value at the start, which is calculated by getting the bound size on the target axis of the object mesh. Currently, the shader uses X orientation. If you want different fill directions, you should change X with Y or Z. While doing so, you can set fill rate to minus progress border to initiate the progress at 0, or set fill rate to 0 and have a half-colored object. This is a piece of fail-safe information for a possible progress behavior implementation to know the progress bar range, meaning for a cube, the range will be minus 0.5 to 0.5. We use position relative to the object, the center is at 0, so the range and fill rate values can start from negative progress border to positive progress border. Fill color is the color that the object is colored when the fill rate increases, and empty color is the initial color of the material, the part that gets consumed by the fill color. You can select any color you would like with these two. It is time for shader graph walkthrough. This is a very simple shader. It takes vertex positions in object space and colors the object with fill rate acting as the border of the colors. Different colors on the opposing sides. As fill rate changes, the border moves. Here we have 6 nodes and 4 properties. Properties were explained previously in the editor. For an overview, you can see the properties and their types on left top corner. When clicked on and inspected, we can also see their string tag to reference it in code. Using split node, we decide which axis to apply progress fill behavior. R for x axis, g for y axis, and b for z axis. To have a different axis variations of the shader, as I did with xyz variations, You can change output offset, split node, and save shader graphs for each axis. I had worked on a selector logic for that, so that one shader will be sufficient with correct parameters, but I'm not satisfied it with yet, but could be a future tutorial concept if you are interested, let me know. Going back to here, from split we get vertex positions in selected axes, and we'll compare them with clamped fill rate in comparison node. Here the fill rate is clamped between the minus progress border value to progress border to limit the fill rate output of fill effect to object specific progress border. Let me explain with an example. As you remember, progress border is 0.5 per cube. If border is set 0.3, we see the clamp, which wouldn't be applicable for object with smaller mesh size. This is my short way of defining the borders, whatever the fill rate will be. This also can be controlled from shader's controller code. From the output of clamp node, we get clamped fill rate. Using multiply node, we get minus progress border and set it to min input of clamp node, and progress border is set to max input of clamp node. Using clamp node, it is confirmed that clamp fill rate will always be between min and max input of clamp node, in other words, progress borders. If you confirm, you will add required logic for controlling the fill rate value to cover the whole 3D object with progress border value and fill rate. You can directly set fill rate to the input of comparison node. To me, branch is a very cool node. In my previous implementation, explained in the written blog post, there were 3 more nodes, but with the correct usage of branch node, they are gone. What branch does is, it sets true input to true part of the predicate and false input to false part of the predicate. The predicate coming from comparison node, which compares A and B under selected node. Here the comparison definition is A is greater than B. The parts A is greater than B will be set as true, and the other parts will be set as false. If vertex position is greater than the calculated fill rate, the output will be true, and that part will be colored with empty color. On the contrary, if the vertex position falls to the left side of the border, as in less than the calculated fill rate, the output of the comparison node will be false, and that means the fill rate was moved and the false part is colored with fill color. And then the output of branch node, the final output is connected to base color. And we have our effect implemented in shader graph. Using this as a start point, you can go wild and design cooler effects. I have prepared some demos for demonstrating different behaviors. If you want to use this shader with multiple game objects with different fill rate, you need to create separate materials for each one. For example, here we have many 3D objects with different fill axes, as well as fill rates, and change in one does not affect change in the other. As in this scene, if you put the same material to multiple objects, when my material reference changes in one object, its effects are shown in the others. Lastly, for an object with multiple materials, each material needs its own material with the shader for different colors. Here is an example I have used the Explorer logo. When I change fill rate, it starts from grayscale and ends colorful, but I change the references of all the materials on the game object. These were examples for using the shader from the editor. To manipulate it with code, there is a short coding demo that I will start now. Here is our behavior. First, let's get to know our variables. Progress steps is the only exposed variable in editor. This tells us what step count we should divide the progress by. As in, if its value is 5, after 5 increments, with no decrease, the progress bar is filled. Fill rate value is the value that we set the fill rate of the shader, starting from minus progress border to progress border. Progress border is defined progress fill range for 3D object that is set in the shader. Step size is the change in fill rate to progress one step on the progress bar. Object material is the reference of the material of the object. At the start, reference of the object material is taken from material of renderer component. If you have multiple materials, you should use materials and update it separately. Progress border value is calculated as previously shown, from the half size of mesh borders of the object. At the start, to initiate the progress empty, fill rate is set to minus progress border. Minimum allowed progress value for the object, and the value also set for the shader. Step size is calculated by dividing the total value of the progress bar by progress steps. By total value, I mean for minus 1 to 1 range, it is 2 in total, 2 times of progress border. In change value, we increase or decrease the fill rate value by the type of call and set the fill rate property of the shader from the material. This is a demo, so there is no logic to check fill rate value exceeding progress border. For healthy progress bar behavior, I highly suggest that you add a control logic for that. Here in the editor, I have two buttons for progressing and deprogressing the item. Also have the game object with shader graph progress bar behavior. On click event of buttons, change value function is called with corresponding variable. Decrease button leaves increase boolean false and increase button sets increase boolean true. When we run the scene, we can change the progress on the 3D object with buttons. We can change the number of progress steps and see their effect. Also on the shader, you can see the unclamped behavior of fill rate relative to progress border value, which is a challenge for you to not get this tutorial any longer. And not gonna lie, this is very fun to play around with the buttons here. This was the code demo. All in all, we have progress fill shader to color 3D objects with two colors to show parts of progress. With further iteration, I believe how the object looks could get more interesting. A peekaboo-like effect would be fun, for example. Hope you will explore more and enjoy what comes out of this. And this was it for this video. If you have any questions, suggestions, or feedback, please let me know in the comments. There are some more topics that I plan to cover for future videos, but I am open for suggestions. If you like this one and want the similar videos, you can give this one a like and subscribe for the future ones. I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!